guys, so I know I've been away for ages now, but I've been really busy with schoolwork and I've been visiting loads of unis because I'm starting university next year, which is really scary. But today I'm doing my first ever after-eve.
I was riding on Beverly by myself. I was working at Yummy, no daylight hell. You were coming over once a week, wearing my lap. Tell me while I cried for the first time in a long time.
Never really good when people are comforting them. My mom died.
Today's kind of like a big day. So, today is the day I move out of my room. And by my room, I mean Bristol. Out of Bristol. And by Bristol, I mean out of uni. I'm moving out of university today. As I said, it's a pretty big day. And I'm not sure how I feel about it.
But I've kind of been dreading today. I've been dreading it for basically two reasons. The first is that I'm kind of lazy and I literally need to pack everything in like half a day. I've got today to pack and it needs to be gone by tomorrow. So that's kind of stressful. This is a year worth of, I have no idea what's even in this room right now. But I think the second reason I've been really dreading it is because although I finished my exams weeks ago now, 3 weeks ago, which is crazy saying 3 weeks ago, I didn't feel like I was leaving uni when I left Bristol and when I went on holiday and I was at home. I just felt like it was another university holiday and that I'd be going back to Bristol because this is where I've lived for the past 3 years. Moving all of my possessions out of my room, there's nothing in Bristol left of me, if that sounds, that probably sounds really weird, but I no longer have a hub or a sense of belonging to a particular place. And I'm kind of struggling to come to terms with that. My dad is picking me up tomorrow, and if everything isn't packed and ready to go, it's staying behind and we are leaving. This is gonna be super stressful and I need your support. If you're watching this, I need your support. So I'm bringing you along with me. We're gonna groove to some cool tunes and we're just gonna pack up my life. We're gonna pack up my life and my identity and yeah, get ready for some tears, some trauma. No, there won't be any tears, but yeah, we need to really get on. Let's do this.
If she died, who gets to keep my cat? Don't know why death.
We've now moved over to my favorite part of the room, my desk space. In all honesty, because I've spent so many hours just sat here working and being like depressed instead of being outside, I'm quite excited to just like get it all clean. This probably has like two layers of like stress sweat on it.
But it did, it's my mom still is, but my cat's gone when my childhood is, when my innocence slips on the.
If you're a student, I'm sure all of that blue tack triggers you so much.
Childhood is when my innocence slips on the pretty street, the demon is from where I sleep.
I've just found a piece of work which always makes me laugh. So basically I'm sorting out my notes and obviously they have all of my like first and second year notes here as well because apparently I thought it was necessary to keep them all. But I've come across an essay I wrote in second year that I had to hand in and I actually did really well in it. Like I got a very high first, which I promise is so rare for me. This is probably the only high first I've ever had. I was so shocked by the fact that I'd actually done like really well in it that I like emailed my tutor and I was like, hi, can I meet with you to discuss my essay? And he was like, yeah. And then I went and saw him and I was like, I'm really confused. I don't understand why I did so well. Like, I really don't think it's that good. And he was like, no, like it made sense, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, no, like, I really don't think it's like as good as you think it is. Like, blah, blah, blah. Basically talking myself out of this grade. And he was like, okay, well, if it makes you happy, I'll take you down a grade. And I was like, so they like grade you on like exceptional, excellent, good, satisfactory, poor, or inadequate. So you can kind of see where my answer lay there. So I originally got 78 and then because I'd gone in to see him, he He crossed out the A and put a 2 and then put a smiley face.
So yeah, the moral of that story is don't ever underestimate yourself so much that you talk yourself out of a higher grade that you were awarded.
Reason smile, but I still did love songs. Song like this,
I'm so tired. I've cleared most surfaces, but I haven't even started my clothes. It's gonna take the longest time, so I think maybe I'm hungry. I might order pizza. Yeah, I'm gonna order pizza.
Okay,
that's enjoy. It. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Have Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
I can't believe I'm moving out tomorrow. I'm not even being emotional about it anymore. I'm so far behind in my packing. Right, we can turn this around. I'm gonna make a very strong coffee and then hopefully we'll get the room finished before it gets too late tonight.
Fuck being modest, got me in bed with you. More alive than ever, quit eating junk food. The same pants all week, got bleach on the side. For when you dye my hair green, looks blue but you try. The times where I thought it was love were just peace.
I have found my glasses that I wore in my first year of university.
Oh my god!
These literally weren't even strong at all, which makes me question how bad my eyesight was. Maybe both? Okay, we have another update on the room. It's now 7:30. I started at 12:30. So what I basically need to do now for the next probably there's a car going past. So what I basically need to do, I have everything in just like little piles. Wow, the only annoying thing now is that my light, wait, what am I talking about? The only annoying thing now is that my room has no working light, as in like this one here, the bulb has gone completely. So we're losing light pretty quickly. So I need to get as much done as possible before the sun sets completely. I just wanna sleep. So it's the next morning. I definitely have more energy today. To give you an idea of what we need to do, everything is now packed and stuffed into one corner of my room. We're basically trying to formulate a system by which we can stack everything in the car without anything getting broken, because I've got a lot of stuff and we haven't got a lot of car. So this is it, this is it. Everything's cleaned, everything's moved out. It's all empty. The super sad thing is that I was checking behind all my bookcases and shelves before I moved out, just to check I've got nothing there. And the one thing that I found was a photo of my dog. So it's time for goodbye. This has been a brilliant year in this house. I filmed so many videos in this room. I'm sure if you've been watching my videos for a while, you recognize this room very well, and I hope you're emotionally sad about leaving it as well. However, there are a lot of exciting things in the future, and I'm looking forward to where I'm going to be moving to next. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it. Comment down below if you have moved out recently, or you've been changing homes, or you're a student. Tell me more. I like to talk to you in the comments. Talk to me. I will see you very, very soon. Goodbye.